Okay, everyone, the second session today is from Mr. Kuku Syafaat. We'll talk about Snap in MicroOS. If you have any question, please put it on the chat box. And if the session has end, you can maybe do a live question and answer. And Mr. Kuku, now the stage is yours.
Okay, thank you, Tika. Okay, let's start. Okay, hello everyone. I'm Kuku from Indonesia. Today I will talk about Snap in MicroOS desktop. This is the updated version of desktop. The previous one was in the OpenSUSE Asia Summit in the last August. And before we start, I will speak about disclaimer of my talk. The first is this is an opinionated presentation, and the second is there are my view and not affiliated with any project. And if you don't agree with my view, it is okay because it is an opinion. So what is Snap? Snap can be packages for desktop, cloud, and IoT. And it is easy to install, but let's see in this talk. It is secure, but let's see also in this talk. And the cross-platform, dependency-free. And the last is developed by the Canonical. And the terminology on Snap is sometimes confusing. What is Snap, Snapd, and Snapcraft? Snap is the boot, the command line interface, and the application package format. Snapd is the background service that manages and maintains your snaps. It's just like a system CTL. And Snapcraft is the command and the framework used to build your own Snap. So if you want to build your Snap, you can use the Snapcraft. And does Snap popular, or are you using Snap? And please tell me in the chat if you're using Snap. Okay, back in 2019, there was a LibreOffice Asia conference. I submitted a talk about LibreOffice Flatpak Snap and App Image. And it comparing those formats in LibreOffice. You can check my talk on my blog and YouTube about LibreOffice Asia conference. And here is one of my slides about people using LibreOffice format instead of native formats like RPM or Debian. And the Flatpak is more popular, following by Snap and App Image. And the survey was taken in Indonesia among LibreOffice user. And then the next year, next in the 2020, and there was a Gymscape Art Week. It is an event for Gym, Inkscape, and other free open source graphic software. I submitted a talk about Inkscape L10N and held a survey about this. You can also check my talk on my blog. And here is the snapshot of what people use Inkscape format on their computer. Most Inkscape user use native format, but interestingly, Snap and Flatpak is on the same number, so it's quite popular among Inkscape user. And this year, in the 2021, in Academy 2021, it was a talk about KDE is all about the apps by Alex Paul Gonzalez from KDE. You can check his talks on the YouTube. And there was one part that he explained about KDE in Snap. So there is a big number on Snap using. Ocular and Krita are the most popular apps on Snap. I believe most of them are Ubuntu users. Okay, so we move to what is the micro OS. Okay, according to the OpenSUSE wiki, OpenSUSE micro OS is an operating system that you don't have to worry about. It is designed for a container, but not limited to container host and edge devices. OpenSUSE micro OS inherits the OpenSUSE Tumbleweed and SUSE Linux Enterprise knowledge while redefining the operating system into a small, efficient, and reliable distribution. You can check micro OS on the internet that there is a micro OS page, wiki, Twitter, and the Matrix and Telegram channel. You can join if you interested in micro OS. And here is some micro OS talks that you can learn more about. Almost of the more about micro OS, you can check the other micro OS talks. And we move to the micro OS desktop. What is the micro OS desktop? So, OpenSUSE micro OS desktop is a micro OS with a desktop focus variant on OS based on Tumbleweed. Micro OS desktop is an immutable and rolling base as based on the Tumbleweed. So the idea of the micro OS desktop is the adding a GNOME or a KDE desktop on the current micro OS distribution. The latest snapshots, GNOME desktop is in beta and KDE is in alpha. You can try the boot desktop, GNOME and KDE Plasma. And here is some micro OS desktop talks that you can learn more about. Most of them also from the OpenSUSE conference. And the latest one was the Road to Daily Driving by Dario Fagioli. I will not explain more about micro OS desktop. You can check the other talks on the YouTube. Okay, next, what is an immutable OS? Immutable OS is a OS that it can be changed. Something cannot be changed during runtime. You cannot modify. You cannot install packages. You will have a hard time installing packages. Also, you will have a hard time to modifying. It is a root read only. It is snapshot. It can roll back to the latest snapshots, and the update not touch the running system. And usually, you need to reboot after update. Here is the immutable OS example: the micro OS, Silverblue by Fedora, and the Endless OS. And this is the comparison between three of them. As you can see on the table, macOS is based on the OpenSUSE Tumbleweed. Silverblue by Fedora is OS 3 based, but it is based on RPM OS 3, and the Endless is OS 3 based also, but it is based on Deep OS 3. Most of them, the file system is BTRFS, but the difference is on micro OS. The default is BTRFS, but we can use the classic subvolume. And on the Silverblue, and root and the home also subvolume. And on Endless, the default file system is the Active4. And the package layer, it means that you can also install the traditional package like Debian or RPM. On the micro OS, you can use the package layer with traditional update, Toolkit or PKCon. On the Silverblue, you can use RPM OS 3, but on Endless, you cannot use package layer since it truly and fully immutable. And the for Flatpak, three of them are supported, but with the different remote. Micro OS use FedHub remote, Silverblue use Fedora Flatpak remote, and Endless combining Endless and the remote. And especially for the Snap, for macOS, you can see this talk until the end. Silverblue, there is a GitHub issue on CoreOS that Silverblue won't snap, and the endless snap is not supported. And the next is I forget to mention this one. This is a Genome OS. So what is a Genome OS? Genome OS is an image deliverable of genome release and the continuous build. Play Genome OS is used for testing application, UX, and hardware. And the using OS 3 atomic update with the endless updater and the genome software. So Genome OS is based on OS 3 also, and I think it is immutable. And you can try the brand new Genome 41 with Genome OS. Genome 41 released a couple days ago, so you can try with the Genome OS. And how about Snap in the OpenSUSE lib or Tumbleweed and the macOS? In the two kind of the OpenSUSE lib and Tumbleweed, there is I think four or five steps. The first one is a add the repository from the repo. You use a lib, just the OpenSUSE lib, or you can use the Snappy repo in the Tumbleweed, and import the JPG key and the zipper dump from the new repo, install Snappy, and enable on the system CTL. So back into the slide, is it really easy to install Snap? Since there was five steps, I think it is not easy to install the Snap. And how about installing Snap in the macOS desktop? In the early version, the macOS use a transactional update, so we must use a transactional update to going into the shell, and then the rest of all is the same command like the installing a Snap in the Tumbleweed. And the new one, OpenSUSE macOS, use a toolkit for to replace the transactional update. So the basic command to going to the shell is to get continue execute, and the rest is also the same. You need to add a repo, refresh the GPG, and install snapd, and exit, and restart the system. And remember that snap needs mount snap directory into the root. And remember also that it is a immutable system and the root is read only. And luckily in the macOS we can use a snare subvolume, so we can create a subvolume for the snap directory in the root system. And the last one is the enable it in the system CTL. Enable snap and the snap the app art mode. And the last one is try to install and run a snap app. Basically, snap has a app called Hello World, so we can check whether the snap is run or not. But wait, on the macOS, when we install it, there is a error message. It tells that a system does not fully support SnapD, cannot mount SquashFS image using SquashFS. Why? Yeah, it's a headache. Another problem arise. So the problem is here, SI Linux. The macOS desktop has a SI Linux and it is enabled by default. So you can check with the command SI status, and the output is a SI Linux status is enabled. So when you install for the first time, on the installation settings, the SELinux default mode is enforcing. You can see in the security section, number 4, SELinux default mode is enforcing. And here's the detail, you can see in the corner, right corner on the bottom, SELinux mode is enforcing. You have to change from enforcing to the disabled. So if you install the OpenSUSE MicroOS desktop, you have to disable SELinux on installation for the fresh installation. Change to the disabled, and then you can finish the installation. So here is the solution about the current installation with SELinux. For the fresh installation, you have to disable SELinux on the installation. But for the current installation with SELinux enforcing or enabled, you need to change the SELinux configuration on kernel. You have to change from 1 to 0. And there's a warning that after booting with disabled SELinux, you have to auto-relabel again, otherwise unlabeled files could lead to unbootable system. You can see the explanation on the SELinux wiki page. So here is the example on the kernel. So you have to change the SELinux from 1 to 0, so you can disable the SELinux. So after booting, you can check the command with SSH status, and the output is SELinux disabled. Try to install the Hello World. Here's the screenshot that we can install Hello World. We can run Hello World. All after we disabled SELinux. And we can try the another Snap application. We can try the Firefox with Snap install Firefox and the Snap run Firefox. And here's the result. As you can see that the Firefox is the can run on the Snap on the macOS. But in my opinion, that the performance is bad and getting slow. And also the branding on the Firefox is the state that Firefox Snap on Mozilla Firefox Snap for Ubuntu. Although we install it on the another system rather than Ubuntu. And here is another post from the UMG Ubuntu. Isn't it the Firefox Snap slower? And does it really slow? You can read the OMG Ubuntu about the Ubuntu will mix Firefox Snap as its default browser rather than Firefox in depth or debian format. And back to this slide, does it really secure when we disable SELinux? Since SELinux is a security enhanced Linux and we disable it, I don't think so. The Snap is really, really secure on the another system that use SELinux. The other problems that happen in the Snap application is that phone not detected. We can fix it with this solution. Remove the cache of the phone config and then recheck again the phone config and the phone will show. Another problem is that the Snap cannot read the home directory, and also the another problem is the when we run the Snap application on the micro SD that cannot mount to the temporary blah 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 not source file or directory. For the solution, based on my experience, is that because macOS is based on Tumbleweed, always update the system to the latest snapshot, and this problem usually fixed after update including updating snapd or the kernel, and sometimes reinstall the snap app may work too. So like this problem, I can uninstall poedit and then reinstall again, and sometimes the application can work again. And here's about my situation according snap application in the macOS is that I use an application called X. X is a multi-platform. X is available for Linux in Snap and the Flatpak. And the license of the X application is MIT, and the source code for the open source version is available on GitHub. But also that X application has a pro version or paid version that has a nice feature that simplify workflow for user. So if you pay the pro version, you have a nice feature that that will help your work. But unfortunately, the X application pro version in Linux is only available on Snap. And here is my thread off about the situation that not use X application anymore. It means that I must move to the another application or still use the X open source version without nice feature. So stay in the open source version that we will use in the X application. Or the number three is the use X pro version, but in the different situation, we can install the pro version in the another computer or operating system or the another Linux that supports Snap, or install point A or B still on the immutable OS, but install it on the virtual machine. And the last one, still install in the OpenSUSE macOS, alpha or beta, and always remember it will break anytime and it's challenging. And you should remember that macOS is still in alpha for KDE and beta for GNOME, and it will always remember that it will break anytime. And here is a last note. Here is an update from the mailing list. If you ask Snap to the developer of the macOS desktop or as Snap on the mailing list, remember that Snap does not officially supported by OpenSUSE macOS desktop team. And if you still use Snap on the macOS, do at your own risk, because it will break anytime. And here's a further reading about macOS desktop. The next one is the first one from Dario Fagioli, macOS as your desktop prime time. And the second one is the running Snap on the macOS as the desktop. And I also read using Snap on the macOS in two parts in my blog, but it is on Indonesian. And the last one, there was a OpenSUSE documentation for installing Snap, but since Snap does not officially support it, the documentation removed this documentation page about installing Snaps in the macOS. Okay, I think that's all from me. I think we still have time. We can check the current question or need anything.
Yeah, everyone, if you have any question for Mr. Kuku presentation, please feel free maybe to turn on your microphone or put it on the chat box.
Looks like
English.
no question.
Yeah. Okay. If we have no question, then thank you, Mr. Kuku, for the great presentation about Snap in macOS and give your opinion about Snap. And we will have a short break time after this. We will have the second session in maybe 6 minutes. Thank you, Mr. Kuku, again, and see you in next event.
Yes, thank you, Tika, and thanks to the first Ubucon Asia attendee yesterday and today. And see you all, and stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you.